It's okay to eat fish, 'cause they don't have any feelings. Something in the way. Something in the way. Yeah.
How you doing, lovely people? I hope you're having a lovely day, and welcome to Dan Guitar, where you'll find fun, easy to follow lessons for the beginner guitarist. So today I'm going to show you how to play Something in the Way by Nirvana. One of my students requested I do a tutorial on this tune. They're a big Nirvana fan. I don't blame them. A great band and a great song, especially good if you're a beginner, because this song only contains two chords. This is also a good way into bar chords, because while you're not playing the whole bar across the neck, you are playing the bottom three strings, so you're barring the bottom three strings for one of the chords. So it's a good way to gradually wean yourself into bar chords as well. So before we dive in, I just want to mention that this tune, originally Nirvana would tune down half a step. So the tuning will actually be D flat, A flat, D flat, G flat, B flat, and E flat. I'm in standard tuning, but I've dropped the low E string down to D. So we have drop D tuning. If you want to play along with the original, you just bring everything down another half a step. So without further ado, let's dive in, and I'm going to show you how to play this song. Okay, so while this song only contains two chords, it can be a little bit overwhelming if I just dive straight in saying, here's the chords, here's the rhythm. That's quite a lot of work if you're a beginner. So what we're going to do first is discuss the rhythm involved. And we're actually going to practice clapping it. Here's how it sounds when I'm playing it. Okay, so what I'm going to get you to do, try and follow along with me, is we're going to try to clap the rhythm. So here's the rhythm. So rhythmically, I would count that as 1, 2, and a 3, 4, and a 1, 2, and a 3, 4, and a. And before having to worry, once you've got that, before having to worry about changing chords and applying that rhythm, first of all, just practice strumming that rhythm across open strings. So, the strings I'm playing are the bottom three, so that's the D, low D now, A and D string, so. So strings 6, 5, and 4 together, and the strumming pattern for that is down, 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 up, down, 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 up. But before you have any reference to the rhythm, like the way we count it and clapping it, it's not as easy as said. So practice clapping it first and counting it the way that I just suggested. That will help you quite a lot. Remember to keep your wrist fairly loose. So you want to imagine that if you're holding your wrist out straight like this, and then just drop your wrist, lose any tension in the wrist like this, just drop the wrist, and it's that movement. Imagine you're shaking water off your wrist. That's the idea. So. And that allows minimal movement with the strumming hand, because if you go too far, you're going to get that, okay? So now we've discussed this, let's move into the chord. So what I'm doing here is I'm playing my first finger, I'm barring that across the 6th, 5th, and 4th string on the 4th fret. Remember to keep your finger nice and close to the fret wire, the metal bit, on the right-hand side of the fret. If you go too far to the left, you're gonna get that muting sound, yeah? So always keep it nice and close to the right, and that's where you're gonna get the clarity of the chord. It's fairly slow as well, so you don't have to worry about playing too fast. So once we've played that strumming pattern once on this chord here, we're gonna release our finger, and then we're gonna play the same strumming pattern on the open strings, okay? So,
underneath
Yes, it's just literally a repeating pattern between those two chords. One thing I want to mention is that when you release your first finger, make sure you're still relatively close to the fourth fret and to the right hand side, because if you come completely away, then you're going to struggle to get back. You want the timing to be accurate, and this is going to enhance the timing by ensuring our first finger is close to where we're going next. So always think ahead, guys, yeah? So whenever you're changing chords, you want to think, what can I do now to make the next move easier? So thank you for tuning in, everyone. That was my tutorial on how to play Something in the Way by Nirvana. And it literally is just that pattern all the way through, that strumming pattern between those two chords. Super easy. So thanks again for tuning in. Do not forget to hit that like button, subscribe for more easy to follow, fun tutorials. Have a lovely day, everyone, and I'll see you again soon.